So how has your experience with working with actors like Akshay?
Yeah, Akshay Na is a very like when I first met him, like we didn't have too much screen time together.
Yeah.
Like there we've I think we only have three scenes together in the
Okay.
entire show.
Okay.
Because that's the entire aspect of the show that we don't even
Yeah.
see face to face. And I've seen all his work, like most of his work. And he's a fabulous actor. I think he's one of the, he's one of those actors who probably, you know how they say you're a critically acclaimed actor and you're a massy actor. I think he's a, like everyone loves the fact about how he works and how, he's known for his acting and he's a good looking guy. And I think there's so much to, when you are working with somebody like him, you're always on your toes because you don't want to underperform. You want to actually overperform yourself. Like if you want to do 100, you want to do 150 for yourself and for the scene. And I think that's where it helps. We didn't spend too much time together on set or before the show. I know I just met him once before the show. So I think it also helped keep the mystery that the two of us had amongst us. So we were not very friendly, which was not required anyways in the show. तो कभी कभी क्या होता है because when you're very like when you're very pally, like too pally also sometimes gets like you into trouble. So I think that also helped because we didn't work together. I didn't know what he was shooting. He didn't know what I was shooting because also कभी कभी ये होता है that I have the first scene of the day and you have the last scene. That also didn't happen because the entire show was set up only in two different areas. So the day he was shooting, I would not shoot. So it's great to work with someone like him. Like I've known him. I knew Simran also before. I knew Parina also. Rohan I met on the set. So I think it's all in all I've realized with Sacred and now with Bakud that you have to have different people who bring the best of themselves to make something really big. Otherwise, one person cannot drive a show, especially on the web today, because the web's not like a certain character-driven arena. Like films में हो जाता है, a film actor क्योंकि 3 घंटे की फिल्म होती है, चलो एक एक्टर की वजह से लोग चले जाते हैं. टेलीविजन में हो जाता है कि शो चल रहा है तो चल रहा है, तो लोगों को पसंद आ रहा है. बट वेब बिकॉज इट्स एपिसोडिक एंड यू विल नॉट ओनली जस्ट बी द स्टोरी ऑफ द शो, सो एवरीवन हैज़ टू बी ऑन देयर टोज, एवरीवन हैज़ टू परफॉर्म वेल. एंड आई थिंक दैट्स वाई इफ यू एवर वॉच इट, इफ यू हैव टाइम, आई कैन ले अ बेट, देर इज़ नॉट इवन अ मिनट दैट यू गेट बोर्ड.
Yeah, I think with the, all that things, it's like that. Like,
No, like character-wise also, like I remember Vignesh, my director, he changed the juniors because he did not like the way they were performing. So if he's taking that much, care about even if someone has like a single line in the show, you don't want A for that actor. That actor should not feel that just because he or she has a single line, he or she doesn't mean anything. And B, you as a director or as a maker, you want even him to perform really well. So I think that's why when that happens, the show cumulatively, I think, looks very weak.
Okay, nice. So you have worked for films, you've worked with like web series, and you have your own good name, like a very big name in TV series. So what would you say that, what's your favorite platform?
Guys, this question has been asked me a lot. There is nothing called as favorite. I'm an actor and I'm an anchor. तो आप मुझे कहीं भी एक्टिंग करने को बोलोगे या कहीं भी एंकरिंग करने को बोलोगे, आई विल हैप्पीली डू इट टिल द टाइम आई एम एंजॉइंग इट. टीवी विल ऑलवेज कम फर्स्ट बिकॉज टीवी इज गिवन मी एवरीथिंग एल्स. टीवी नहीं होता तो मैं होता ही नहीं. The entire aspect of working on different platforms was only there's so much competition today, so I'd rather not keep saying no to things and satisfy my ego. And realized 10 years from now that I'm not done anything in life, and I've just said no, and I was very happy saying no, that oh, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do that. When I left, or when I took a break from mainstream fiction television, that was because I told myself I'm making a lot of money, but I now also want to do something that that makes me happy every day of my life. Like I should go on set and be happy about it, because that's why I'm working. Yes, I know off days sabke hote hain, but like even if if you are not enjoying, and if you are like just coming to office every day and saying, "Arey yaar, kyun aa gaya main," you'll eventually say, I don't want to do this. So when nobody was doing web 3 years back, I started doing web, and people were like, dude, paisa nahi hai, ye nahi hai. So my entire aspect only was that paisa kamana to main wahan kama lunga. Because if I'm leaving TV for good content, and then if I'm getting good content, which I like, and I'm leaving it for good money, then I don't know what I want in life. So that's why I think I just kept on doing things, and I always believe that, you know, work gives you more work. So today, you know, after Sacred came, Barcodes come, I'm doing three more things. I'm the same actor that probably I was 5 years back, but probably, you know, when you don't get opportunities, you have to either find yourself some, or you have to just be very lucky. So
what are you right now?
I'm a mixture of two. I think both of them. I think I've been lucky. That I've survived 14 years now. I think once in a blue moon, when I feel that, you know, I'm being very complacent, then I go hard at it.
I've been watching. I was in school.
Why? Just before you make me feel really old.
When I started watching Dil Mil Gaya, and I remember you seeing continuously, like somewhere or the other, which is good.
Yeah, which is, I think that's what it is. See, at the end of the day, I'm an actor. Like, you know, when people say, "Oh, I'm an actor," unfortunately, a lot of people don't understand the meaning of being an actor.
Yeah.
You do a fiction or you do a reality show. I would not want to name reality shows out here and get into trouble, but you do a reality show, come to Bombay, and you think you're an actor. You're not an actor. You're a reality soap star. This word is not there in our Indian dictionary only, first of all. If you're an Instagram sensation, you're not an actor. If you have a million followers, the population of the world is 7.4 billion, not even a percentage. So nothing to be egoistic about. So I think it's just that, you know, like I've always, when I came to Bombay, I told myself one thing which I've not forgotten still. I replace somebody, someone's going to replace me. So I'd rather enjoy it till it lasts and make the most out of it. And that's why I think everyone keeps seeing me somewhere or the other, because I never say no to work, because I just, that's what I'm here for. If I'm not a working actor, I'm not an actor. So I think it's just that. Thankfully, she's just seen me through since Dil Mil Gaya.
Because
were you born in 2004?
No, I was born in 1998.
She was in first standard when I was working. Thanks. Behind the camera, somebody makes me feel really old.
Okay.